What excites you the most about this year, and what concerns you the most?
Excites me the most is probably the opportunity that we have to perform at the highest level. You know, when you look at playing Alabama and Notre Dame, the Pac-12 Conference, you talked about an unbelievable opportunity to show who you are and to compete. And that's why you come to SC. You come here to compete and to play the best of the best. If you want to be the best, play the best. What's my biggest worry? Biggest worry is probably the thinness a little bit at defensive line. We're going to be a little thin there, a little bit inexperienced. It kind of reminds me of, you know, remember when Damian and Viotti and Toba Lobodon were all true freshmen, and I was an OC offensive coordinator. I'm looking out there and going, oh my God, we're playing three true freshmen. You know, it doesn't mean that they're not talented. They're just inexperienced. And, you know, we'll do things as coaches to be able to help us, you know, help a young offensive line, you know, load the box. There's going to be more pressure put on our defensive backs to play some man coverage and to help a defensive line, whether it's pressures or dropping a safety in the box, whatever it might be. You know, we'll do those things to help them. But that's probably my biggest concern, is how that defense works.
And if you don't like that line, go take the job. That's what we expect as coaches. That's what I expect as a head coach, is to be at a championship level. And to be able to do that, we need to progress as these guys and how they're working. How they're training every morning, 5 days a week at 6:30 a.m. I think they're doing a tremendous job running their own practices during this summer, doing the things that it takes, not one to come together as a team, but also to produce a caliber and level of football that we're going to need to have the opportunity to play at Alabama, a Notre Dame, a Utah State, and a Pac-12 schedule. Man, is that awesome. Because the fact of the matter is we live in a playoff system world. And everybody's going to be talking about building your resume. Well, when you play Alabama, when you have a chance to play Alabama, Notre Dame, that Pac-12 schedule, you're building your resume. But you know what you're also doing? You're preparing yourself for a playoff game. You're preparing yourself for a national championship game. Because the quality of talent that you're playing throughout the season prepares you when it matters the most, and that's those playoff and championship games. So I can't tell you how excited that we are to have the opportunity to play a defending national champion, to play one of the top head coaches in the history of this game, in Nick Saban. I think it's given us a little bit of a kickstart, you know, in the summer, and really has made our football team have a little chip on their shoulder. I can say I've been around them for 6 years, and this summer feels a little bit different, and I'm so proud of the work that these guys are putting in. You know, this season is about competing, and there'll be several competitions. I've had a number of questions already about our quarterback position, as well as several, you know, positions. And that's what USC is about. It's about competing. You know, we do have a quarterback battle that's going on right now. We're very, very fortunate and thankful to have some really talented guys at the position. And, you know, coming out of spring, like I said, after that spring game, we had to finish that day and play the next week. It probably would have been next round. But the separation between Max and Sam Darnold was not great. And if we talk about competing at every position, it's got to be the quarterback position also. What will we do? What is the plan? The plan is to go for about 18 practices and see where all our positions are at. And then about 2 weeks out, prior to playing that opening game versus Alabama, we'll go ahead and release our 2D and let every young man know what his role is going into that first game. I've played quarterback, I've coached a position. I know exactly that you want to know, and your team wants to know, who the leader is going into that first game. So we'll make that going into about 2 weeks prior to that opening game when we go into our mock game here. I feel so fortunate to have the opportunity to coach the young men that you've been a part of their lives for 6 years that you love. Two of them are here with me today. Zach Banner, our senior offensive lineman, who is definition of a Trojan and what we want to be as a Trojan. A young man that already has his degree, playing his final year of eligibility, has been the rock of our offensive line for a number of years and is really the leader of our group up front, really on both sides of the ball. He's becoming the senior leader. And then you got Dory Jackson, in my mind, one of the most special talented athletes there are in the country. For him to do what he did at the Olympic trials just blows me away. Be one of the top 10 jumpers in this country, then be a finalist for the Olympic trials, and then do what he does on the football field, and be the type of person that he is. makes you very thankful as a head coach that you have young men around just like these guys.